In 1951, Gene Kelly and Leslie Caron starred in a whimsical movie where three friends struggle to find work in Paris. Things become more complicated when two of them fall in love with the same woman. It's aptly titled An American in Paris.
C'est magnifique!
Wonderful! Marvelous! She should care for me.
Paris is a mood, a longing you didn't know you had until it was answered. Paris is like, it's like love or art or faith. It can't be explained, only felt.
That movie has been turned into a stunning production on Broadway that has won 4 Tony Awards, and now the Australian Ballet and GWB Entertainment are bringing it to our stages.
That's right, and we'll be checking in with some of the cast later today, but right now we are joined by the production's lead producer, Torben Brookman, at the Queensland Performing Arts Centre in Brisbane. Torben, this production has been a huge success on Broadway. How exciting has it been for you to bring this to Aussie stages?
Look, Maddie, it's been amazing. This is a piece of work that's 4 years in the making to bring it to Australia. We've been sort of, if we first saw this show, we saw it in London, we've seen it in Paris, and it's just the most amazing, sweeping, epic musical that you can imagine. So the stage show takes the base work of the movie and then just explodes all that on stage in this beautiful, rich explosion of colour and movement and exquisite dancing. It's been put together by director-choreographer Chris Wilden, who's just an incredible choreographer and director. He's currently working on Broadway, actually. He's the director-choreographer for the new Michael Jackson musical, MJ. So Chris's credentials are unsurpassed, and he's put this brilliant piece of a very balletic work but crafted it into this incredible piece of magical musical theatre.
For those who aren't aware, how significant is this movie and story in cinema history, and how can we expect to see it portrayed on stage?
Yeah, look, it's one of those iconic pieces of cinema history that really found its place and went down into one of the iconic, lavish Hollywood blockbusters of its time. The transition to stage has been a really interesting process. It uses that base material of the movie, but it's got this beautiful score by George and Ira Gershwin, so those incredible Gershwin melodies and tunes, and then the choreographic pieces that Chris has put together are incredible. And then designer Bob Crowley has created this beautiful sweeping design. It's sort of like some of the costumes are actually here with me at the moment, but Bob basically designs like he's painting. So these beautiful, epic, sweeping designs from Bob from a costume perspective. And then there's incredible projection design right the way through by 59 Productions out of the UK. So it's one of those incredible sort of pieces of work that's the perfect fusion of dance, music and acting that comes together in this major, lavish, beautiful production.
Now, Torben, you've got some costumes there. Can you talk us through some of the key pieces?
I do, yes.
And where they fit into the production?
Look. Yeah, absolutely. So there's a few pieces here. There's these are some of the costumes that a character called Milo Davenport wears. There's a dress here of Lise, who's the beautiful young ballet dancer. And then back into some of the costumes that Jerry wears, which is sort of the very 50s sort of iconic, you know, soldier uniform and 50s wear. So Jerry is played by an incredible performer, Robbie Fairchild, who's joined us from the US, actually. So he originated the role of Jerry on Broadway and has played it in Paris and in the West End. And equally, the performer playing Lise is Leanne Cope, and she also originated these roles alongside Robbie. So it's really rare in Australia that we get the opportunity to have the people who actually originated the roles on Broadway and in the West End come and join us in Australia. And then the exciting thing is that we've then got these incredible young Australian stars, Dimity Azuri and Cameron Holmes, who are playing the alternate Jerry and Lise. So they do 2 performances a week, and Robbie and Leanne do 6. So it's an incredible kind of cast who bring this life. Some of these costumes probably don't quite do it justice. When you see them up on stage under light, it's just an incredible piece.
And as you say, the music is simply incredible, the Gershwin tunes. Thank you so much for joining us, Torben.
And we are joined by the production's lead dancers, Robbie Fairchild, who plays Gene Kelly, and Leanne Cope, who is the Leslie, is it Caron?
Caron.
Caron.
I like to say Caron.
They are at the Queensland Performing Arts Centre in Brisbane. Robbie, you're stepping into the dancing shoes of legendary Gene Kelly. How have you prepared, and are you feeling a little bit of pressure right now?
Well, when somebody like Gene Kelly is your reason for becoming a dancer, you are more honored than anything to be getting to dance in his shadow, in his footsteps. When we did this show originally, no other person had played Jerry Mulligan besides Gene Kelly, so to get to have that kind of proximity to your idol is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And luckily, we have different choreography, so it's not like there's like a side-by-side who did it better. It's just, it's an homage to what they did,
sure.
So it's an honour.
Leanne, due to the pandemic, you and the cast haven't been able to perform for almost 2 years. How does it feel to be back on stage and working with dancers like Robbie from New York?
It's just a great honour to be back on stage because there's so many people that can't be right now. So it's been wonderful to experience an audience again. It always makes me think back to, well, in the UK, we used to clap for carers once a week, and how much I now appreciate, and I always did, but appreciate people clapping for us, and we've not done anywhere near as much as what everyone did to help us get through the pandemic. But it's really wonderful to have an audience again, and to be dancing with Robbie again is just, well, it's, this show is the gift that keeps on giving for the two of us, I think.
And Leanne, we can see one of your co-stars, Dimity, doing some warm-ups behind you right now. How important is it to warm up properly as a ballerina?
It's really important, especially when you're doing 8 shows a week. Because this show, it's primarily a musical. There is ballet involved, but we all do our ballet warm-up at the beginning of the day, and it's kind of integral to the show that we do this warm-up for injury prevention and to just kind of get our technique as top form as we possibly can be to do this difficult choreography by Christopher Wheeldon. So, yeah, a ballet bar, centre, and even jumps if we've got the energy is really important.
And that beautiful music from the Gershwins, just tremendous.
It's incredible.
Is there any Aussie slang that you guys have picked
up
along the way whilst you've been here?
Yeah, no. How was that? Was that good? Yeah, no. Yeah, no. They're working and they're teaching me.
Yeah,
have you caught anything?
Utterly perfect.
Oh, I'm terrible. I feel like I would insult the whole nation if I tried.
No. Yeah, no.
Well, I just did, so there you go.
Spot on, Robbie. Thank you both so much for joining
Great.
Us. An American in Paris is on in Brisbane until January the 30th. It then heads to Adelaide, Perth, Melbourne and Sydney. Tickets are on sale via americaninparis.com.au. Thanks both so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.